California cotton. 10 pesos, he clears them all.
Cleanly?
Cleanly.
Taken.
Grow wings, my friend.
Row, row, get me to shore.
Where can I get a carriage to drive me to Los Angeles? Well, wake up! Didn't you hear me?
Si, senor. Si, senor.
This way. Pedro! Pedro! Here's a caballero who'll employ you. He's the son of His Excellency, the Alcalde. I want to be driven to Los Angeles. I have some boxes and a portmanteau on the wharf. Stop staring at me. Will you drive me or not? What's come over this country? Have you all gone mad? Listen, you. Find speech or I'll cut out your tongue.
You are too late, senor. Your good father has already attended to that.
Father, what are you talking about?
I am sorry, senor. But I at a meeting of the peons, this man spoke against the heavy taxes. The next day, Excellency, cut out his tongue. I swear it is true.
Tell me, Who holds the office now?
Luis Basilio Quintero. I'll take you to him.
Oh, thank you, but I should like to see my family as quickly as possible. Where are they living?
At your old hacienda. But His Excellency will never forgive you if I let you go without a word of welcome from him. I'm quite sure that you'll save me a reprimand.
How could I refuse a man anything with a naked sword in his hand?
Ha ha! The wit has come to Los Angeles. Carry out your orders, Sergeant.
See.
Foolish habit of mine. Some men play with a glove, or a monocle, or a snuff box. Churchmen finger their beads. I toy with a sword. Do you fancy the weapon?
Oh, I know very little about it, my dear Capitan. Swordplay is such a violent business.
So, this is the bird that killed the black-breasted wren, eh?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Was it a bloody battle?
The sight of the pit. All the people were covered with blood.
Pity I missed it. What are you asking for him?
No, this is a noble bird, well tested. I'm asking 40 pesos for him.
40 pesos? Esteban! This cheating dog should have his taxes raised.
Oh, no, Your Excellency. The bird is yours as a gift. Not one centavo will it cost you.
That's a better attitude. Much better.
Turn him over to my handlers.
Senor.
And what caballero is this? Or is he
Spain? A good guess, Excellency. He's just from Spain. This is Don Diego Vega, son of your respected predecessor.
I thought such fabric came from Madrid. Must have cost you plenty, eh?
The caballero is here for some words of welcome, not to discuss the price of his clothes, Excellency.
Oh, of course, to be sure. Welcome back, young sir. Regard this house as still your home.
Thank you, Your Excellency.
Luis! Luis! Spain! The shops will have something worth looking at last. I need...
Money. Money, money. It's always money.
Luis, I don't know this caballero.
He's just off your precious ship from Spain.
Oh, how delightful. Will one of you ill-mannered boors present him?
Don Diego Vega, Senora Inés de Quintero.
My wife, senor.
Senora, Your Excellency is a very fortunate man.
I'm not so sure. She thinks pesos grow on mulberry trees.
The husband was also fascinated by the caballero's clothes. Your pardon, senor. We're overwhelmed by the latest fashions.
No wonder. What is there here to interest a woman? I long for the life you've been leading, senor. The gaiety and splendor of Madrid and the court.
Have patience, my love. You'll see it all someday.
Doubtless, when I'm an old hag.
That catastrophe could never overtake you, senor.
Oh, how easily he makes pretty speeches.
I regret, senora, that...
You were saying, Don Diego?
Oh, yes, I was saying that I must tear myself away and make some speeches to my father and mother.
Oh, don't leave me to these barbarians. Come to the shops with me and help me make my selections.
Now, you tempt me, senora. I love the shimmer of satin and silk, the matching of one delicate shade against the other. Then there's the choosing of scents and lotions. Attar of rose, carnation, crushed lily, and musk. As for ornaments,
endure. But my love, Don Diego must see his parents.
Too true. Duty rather than pleasure.
Excellency. Capitan.
Taxpayers?
Only when they're stubborn.
When you come to collect my taxes, Sergeant, I won't be stubborn, I promise you. Turn right in here, driver.
Adios, senor.
Adios.
Muscle, you men,
Madre de Dios! Is he without a face? Can't you see he's even better looking than when he left?
No, Mother. You should have seen me when I approached the Spanish throne for the first time. They said I looked like a frightened gopher.
More like a...
An angel. That's what we need in California now. An angel with a flaming sword.
Please don't start that. He didn't come home to get himself killed.
Hold your tongue, Isabel. Go to your women. Leave my son to me. Sit down, Diego.
What is all this, Father?
Well, I am no longer alcalde. In my place is a man...
In his place sits a viper. Foul and so black. Ought to be alone with him for 5 minutes. 5 little minutes. Long enough to tear his windpipe out of his throat. God forgive me.
But why did you resign in the first place, Father?
Resign? I was forced out of office. They threatened to burn the homes of the peons.
And now he sits here doing nothing. When he should...
Enough, Felipe. Enough. The friar urges me to lead the caballero. Surely fail against the garrison-trained soldiers. Even if I thought it would succeed, I'd refuse just the same.
But why, Father?
Because the law is the law, my son. I will not rebel against the government I served for 30 years.
But that government is now vile and corrupt.
I know. But two wrongs don't make a right. And never will.
That is my feeling also.
Sometimes one must fight fire with fire.
I will not follow in the lawless footsteps of Luis Quintero. Nor will my son.
No. No, no, of course not, Father. Oh, by the way, I went directly from the ship to our old home. I met Señor Quintero and his charming wife. I found them very pleasant and agreeable.
Pleasant scorpions, agreeable rattlesnakes.
Oh, Padre. Well, the alcalde spoke with great respect of you, Father.
I must admit he hasn't troubled me or my flocks so far.
Well, that being the case, why get overly excited in this heat? I know I'm going to miss the scented breezes of Spain.
Then you believe that we should not be moved by injustice and cruelty until it touches us?
My dear Padre, such things exist in the world and always will. I took up sleight of hand while I was in Madrid. It's all the rage just now. Watch closely. Well, I must go and remove the dust of travel. Adios, senores. I'll see you later, Father.
Thank you.
don't understand why you insist on this stupid drive. And without an escort.
I have my reasons.
Suppose you share them with me.
Gold. An agent of the Bank of Madrid is meeting us in a quiet inn. This goes to Spain. For us, my love, for us.
I see. How stupid of me. A military guard would...
Let our friend Esteban know about this little transaction.
But of course he would have claimed his share.
I'm afraid so.
Don't move if you want to live.
A bandit.
I have distressing news for your excellency. I had a small drinking bout with the agent of the Bank of Madrid. While in his cups, the fellow was somewhat indiscreet. A drunken man is untrustworthy, Excellency. I will act for him. Hand it over. Now,
you'd rob a woman?
I can't afford gallantries.
I refuse. You dare not take it.
Goodness, Signora, I should hate to mark such a lovely cheek. This time, Excellency, I take only your money. Next time... Adios. Study, Your Excellency. I like a quiet room. Very quiet.
Where do you work?
I want to talk with you and come to an understanding. Do you think the climate in Spain will agree with you?
Why do you ask?
Because you're either going there to some place that you might not like so well. Which will it be?
Spain?
It's a very wise choice. Now to the matter of your successor. What do you think of Don Alejandro's experience?
What does it matter to me?
Nothing. But to the people of this district, a great deal. When you resign, you will appoint Don Alejandro as your successor.
As you wish.
remind you that I've been here once and can return.
What are you going to do? What's that?
That's the point of my sword against your throat. And don't move and don't utter a sound until I take it away.
No.
You won't.
What's this? Are you trying to commit suicide? Speak up! What's the matter?
Esteban. He was here.
Who was here?
Zorro.
Ridiculous. Your fears have had your brain.
I tell you, he was here in this very room.
Fray Ramon, I'm Fray Pablo.
I was asking the Holy Mother to save me from a convent. Is that a sin?
The sin, I think, would be in sending you to one.
I don't understand.
Well, I mean, a young girl with your, I just think that you would probably be more like a convent than in.
You mean serving God?
Yes. Yes, of course, in a way.
In what way, Father?
Well, the church must have sons and daughters, you know, if she is to flourish. You follow me?
I think so. You mean, I might marry?
Yes. Yes, exactly. And find daughters to the glory of God.
I was praying just now for a husband.
You were? Fine. I mean, it's quite natural at your age, my child.
Yes, but it's not natural for a girl of my age to long for a husband to rescue her.
From what?
Father, will you speak to me for a little while? I'm troubled deeply. I wouldn't leave this lonely place. I want to meet young people. Girls of my own age. No one ever comes here. The caballeros avoid this place like the pest house.
Why?
Luis. You know, I feel that there's something wrong about him. Decidedly wrong. What do you think?
Well, people hate him, as you say. You have your answer there.
Right. Perhaps I should be glad my Aunt Inez is sending me to a convent.
No, no, don't be glad about that. I mean, probably your aunt feels that the atmosphere is girl, but I'm convinced.
Oh, Inez! Oh, no, no, that's not why she's sending me.
No?
No. Maria says she's jealous. She says it's because I'm good-looking.
Maria has excellent eyesight.
Thank you, Father, but are you sure? No one except Maria ever says I'm pretty.
Pretty? Are you more radiant, more lovely than a morning in June?
You really think that? I've never heard such words before. They make me almost lose my breath.
You should hear such words every hour of the day.
You're not in the least like Friar Ramon. Talk so strangely. You're wearing a sword.
Maria! Lolita, we've been looking everywhere for you. Zora just broke into the house and threatened your uncle. They think he's still hiding somewhere close by. Come along. Oh, lock the doors after we leave, Fra Ramon. The beast may try to rob the altar.
Good night, Padre.
Thank you.
it left her.
Sergeant.
I'll take that.
Chess with a good padre. It's a dull game, but what can one do?
You've seen or heard nothing?
Of sorrow? Oh, heaven spare me. My blood chills at the thought.
Out of here! Turn the gun off!
What's disturbing you, padre? Thoughts of that bandit?
Puppy!
My dear padre, really?
Think of what one man single-handed has accomplished against these devils.
trembling at the very mention of his name. Why, but can't you even listen to what I'm saying?
Ordinarily, I drink in every word you say, Padre, but just now. Thank you, Mother.
Plunder?
Well, don't stand there gaping at me like a fish. Put it away.
I took from his charming wife. It's pretty, don't you think?
Have you seen this one, Padre?
Zorro.
So my old mentor has no more wit than the rest of them, huh?
Are you trying to make me the receiver of stolen goods?
No, Padre. The dispenser. This gold was wrung from the peons. It's up to us to restore it to them.
Trained troops?
My father was right about that.
But you must have had the accord. You took the gold and the necklace from him. I would have snuffed him out like a candle. God forgive me.
But that would accomplish nothing. Another just like him would take his place.
I see. I see everything. Diego, don't deceive your father any longer. It's not fair to him.
I don't like doing it, Padre, believe me. But I must. He's such a stickler for law and order that I'm afraid he might spoil all the fun.
But what can you hope to achieve all alone? Taking his money?
Oh, no. But I may be able to persuade him to resign and name my father in his place. Amusing, don't you think?
If you live.
Say that you urged me to regard this house as still my home?
Oh, did I?
It's very good of you to remember His Excellency's offer, but didn't you have some trouble getting in?
Oh, no. No, I had a note from Doña Inés asking me to ride with her this morning, and I just showed it to the sentries.
Excellent. Come into my study till my wife appears. It's been Esteban's privilege to ride with her each morning.
Excellency, tell me, why is this house so closely guarded? I swear I saw full company around it.
I wish there were twice as many.
Distraction.
I find it reassuring. Let me show you something, young man. Look.
Madre de Dios. The mark of Zorro.
Mm-hmm. He came here one night. He threatened my life and left that.
From ear to ear. Warned them first, you know, and then...
Santa Maria.
Pity your sense of duty keeps you here, Excellency. Frightful risk.
Sense of duty. Oh, yes. Yes, of course.
Oh, I'm so sorry to have kept you, Don Diego. Esteban was certainly of a heart of a ride. I'd promised the morning to him, it seems.
Signora, your invitation was like a smile from heaven. I was positively suffocating with boredom.
Well, then let's fly. I'm dying for a canter. Oh, goodbye,
goodbye, Excellency.
Goodbye, goodbye. Just told me a horrible tale about a madman in Madrid, like this Zorro. He thinks I'm running a great risk by staying here.
Oh, forget your fears for a moment. I have a plan.
What is it?
Don Alejandro Vega is the natural leader of the Caballeros. Zorro wants you to appoint him in your place. What do you gather from that?
Go on, go on.
Doesn't it suggest to you that Zorro is the tool of Don Alejandro and the Caballeros?
Perhaps, but how can we prove it?
We can at least help the situation.
How?
Form an alliance with Don Alejandro.
Oh, that's impossible. No Vega's attitude.
Perfectly. But Lolita should have a husband. What could be stronger than a matrimonial alliance? Royal families keep the peace of Europe in bridal beds.
Diego and Lolita. Not bad. Not bad at all.
Oh, Diego. Talking with you is like a drink of cool water in the desert.
Oh, it's a pity.
What, Diego?
No, I mustn't make you discontented.
Oh, please. What were you thinking?
Well, I was just thinking how you're being wasted here. Your beauty, your gift for words, your perfect poise. You were born for something higher, civilized than this provincial life you're leading.
I know. May I tell you something, Diego?
Anything?
Yes, of course I may. I felt from the moment we met that we... Diego, Esteban is urging me to leave my husband and go to Spain with him.
Oh, but my dear, no.
But I'm dying here.
Well, go to Spain. Esteban. Husband.
My husband? Go to romantic, beautiful Spain with Luis?
Well, let me explain. As the wife of the one-time alcalde of Los Angeles, you'd be received at court. But as the companion of a second-rate soldier of fortune, you'd be completely ostracized.
Oh, I see. Court, imagine.
But, my dear, in Spain, the husbands of adorable ladies are merely background.
But I'd be lost among so many.
Not you. You need only one friend to introduce you into the proper circles.
But I have no such friend in Madrid.
Who knows? I don't intend to remain in California forever.
Oh, dear.
what you suggest, senor, is utterly impossible.
I'll give the girl a dowry of 20,000 pesos.
No.
25,000.
Are you buying my son, Senor Quintero?
There's always the practical side to consider.
It doesn't enter into this. You come here in broad daylight on a friendly mission with half a company of troops. Why?
Not to threaten you, Don Alejandro. It's because of this sword.
Oh, is only a symptom. This whole district is bleeding raw under your vile administration. I would never appear to condone it by a marriage between our families.
In that case, the friendly attitude I've taken toward you will cease.
Buenas tardes, Excellency.
Oh. What is all this fatiguing turmoil about?
His Excellency has offered a marriage between his niece, Lolita, and you, Diego.
His niece? How flattering. But why should that cause an argument on a hot day?
I have to explain.
Your father resents my efforts to make the people of the district more, industrious than under his regime.
Grinding the taxpayers into poverty and despair to line your own pocket is hardly making the district
a... politics, politics. What have they to do with my marriage?
You'd marry into the family of this...
Well, how can I tell until I've seen her? She may look like her uncle.
Quite right. I... Oh, no, Diego. She's a sweet little dove. Desolate us to have her leave the nest.
If she were Venus, she'd still be his niece.
Yes, but after all, Father, I'm not marrying His Excellency.
Oh.
Diego. But, Diego, don't you think the wishes of your father in this sort of matter should be considered?
Mother dear, I had no say in my father's marriage. Why should he try to instruct me in mine?
Exactly. Will you dine with us tonight, Diego?
Charmed.
We'll expect you at 8 o'clock. Adios, senora.
Diego, Diego, what have you done?
Oh, it'll be all right, Mother. No matter what you think now, please don't worry.
This was your doing, you sly beast. You gave Luis the idea of this marriage.
An alliance for the good of the state, my dear. It's been fashionable since the dawn of history.
Oh, Maria, my knees are shaking. Yes, yes, that is natural. Shall I bow or give him a hand to kiss?
Oh. Then the bow.
It's 20 minutes past the hour. What can be keeping him?
Don Diego Vega.
I was afraid that you might have been waylaid by that Zorro fellow.
Oh, heaven spare me, senora. I am dazzled.
And here's our... Lolita.
I am honored, senora.
Charmed, I'm sure.
May I present, senora Maria de Lopez?
Senora.
Senora.
You'll forgive me for being late, Senora. They heated the water for my bath too early. It was positively tepid. By the time Moore was carried and presented, life can be trying, don't you think?
Yes.
Oh,
Maria.
Courage, courage.
Well, shall we dine? Come, Diego.
His bath was tepid.
Poor Lolita. I'm afraid her wedded life would be the same.
Please do that again. As you wish. Observe closely.
Amazing. Quite so.
Have you seen this one?
No.
Observe very closely.
Oh, frightfully amusing.
It's one for His Majesty.
Oh, it must be heavenly accord.
It's the one bearable spot on earth, my dear. Oh, speaking of that Zorro, Excellency, could you provide me with an escort home?
Certainly.
On the way here, I fancied that cutthroat lurking in every shadow. I was positively unnerved.
How distressing.
Apparently you don't approve of my request, Senorita.
But you called our hero a cutthroat.
Santa Maria, have you met the fellow?
I've never so much as seen his face. I happen to admire courage.
Dashing about with a cutlass is quite out of fashion. Hasn't been done since the Middle Ages.
It seems to be quite effective. He's like a lion among a lot of frightened sheep.
A madman, that's what he is. A madman.
Undoubtedly. Capitan, you seem to regard that poor fruit as an enemy.
A rival.
My dear Esteban is forever thrusting at this and that. He used to be a fencing instructor in Barcelona.
How exhausting.
I didn't find it so.
Then why did you give it up?
I had the misfortune to...
A lady was involved, I believe.
The gentleman's wife, no doubt.
Just how did you mean that, senor?
I hope to be amusing. Have I failed?
Somewhat. With me.
What are the new dance steps, Don Diego? You know them all, I suppose.
I'm afraid so.
Have you shown me?
Gladly.
Inés would enjoy it more, senor.
Nonsense, my child. Dance with him.
Play El Sombrero Blanco.
Mi sombrero blanco, deja que me ponga mi sombrero.
wonderful.
I found it rather fatiguing.
If you'll excuse me, Signor, I wish to retire.
So sorry. What's got into the girl? Who knows?
Our little dove has flown.
I don't like it.
You're not serious about this marriage. You can't be.
But, my dear, it's perfect. You and I can be seen together anywhere in Madrid without the slightest danger of gossip. Excellency, your niece is charming.
A sweet child.
May I plead with you for marriage? A refusal would crush me.
She's yours, my dear Diego, with all my blessings. You understood that. Who's that?
No one.
Forgive me, my dear. I've been an old fool. You seem to know how to handle these matters much better than your Uncle Luis.
See, you took the advice I gave you in the chapel.
Chapel?
About not hiding such beauty in a convent.
What did you say?
You're more lovely, more radiant than a morning in June.
Surely, I must be dreaming.
Yes, Lolita. In order to accomplish what I set out to do, I've had to deceive a great many people, including you.
Oh, yes, I see. I understand. You don't have to explain. You came here to tell me that asking to marry me was just part of the game.
Oh, no, Chiquita. No, that's the one real thing about this whole masquerade.
Go. Lolita! Lolita!
Yes, I'm coming. You seem upset, my dear. Have you been crying?
Yes, I have.
I understand. This marriage was your uncle's idea. The man's not at all the type for you. He's far too sophisticated.
You really think so, Inez?
Oh, beyond a question. I saw how he affected you tonight. My heart bled for you, my dear. When you tell Luis you'll have none of this marriage, you can count on my...
I hardly know what to say. Uncle Luis has done so much for me.
But nonsense. He has no right to expect you to spoil your life.
Oh, well, any marriage is better than none, I suppose. Perhaps I could learn to tolerate Diego. Why, I do so want to please Uncle Luis.
There's such a thing as... I can't ask you to spend your life with a man you think repulsive. We'll talk of this again in the morning. Good night, my dear.
Good night.
Steps toward making you a grandfather.
What? What a son you bore me.
The Lions were those terrible people. Son, why did you do it?
For the best reason in the world, Mother.
What is that?
Lolita Quintel.
She attracts you?
The day I first saw her...
I thought you hadn't met her until tonight.
Well, I did catch a glimpse of her some time ago, and...
You're concealing something from us, son. I'm sure of it.
It's time you went to bed.
Very well. But, Diego, tell me as soon as you can.
I will, Mother.
Sergeant Gonzalez. He's gone. Where? To Hades, I hope. I'll collect the mission tax. That should teach them. What's that? You!
that, so I say. I think he's dead.
Dead? Dead, you say?
Oh, he's alive.
He's got a Z on his chest. Zorro.
I come at precisely the right moment, it seems.
I'll take that.
These are the funds of the mission. The property of the church.
Not any longer. Hand them over.
I refuse.
In that case, I shall take them.
No!
The church. Where'd you get this?
I'll tell you nothing. Run me through and have done with it.
No, my dear Padre. We shall presently hang you. Come on.
Senorita,
will you answer me one question?
Certainly, senor.
Do you want to marry my son?
Yes.
Why?
Well, I love him, senor.
You are right, my son. She is like the flower.
Not yet.
Look, so far I've only frightened your uncle. This may mean that I'll have to do more than that. Do you understand? But if that becomes necessary, will it make any difference between us?
Sentries! Sentries! There's someone in that chair! Seize him! Diego! Here! You frightened me half out of my wits!
Oh, this is too much, really. It's distressing enough to call on my betrothed and not find her at home. Now to be manhandled by these two ruffians.
Leave us! Leave us!
Lolita, Excellency, no one seems to know.
Oh, riding, driving, walking. What does a young girl do?
Am I to understand that my betrothed wander about the countryside without a duenna? I protest, Your Excellency. I protest strongly.
I can't discuss that now. Do you know this Zorro had an accomplice? A priest.
What?
We arrested him today. And another horrible thing happened to me this morning. Sergeant Gonzalez was beaten half to death by this Zorro. He shoved him over the wall right before my eyes.
How frightful. But after all, it was harder on Gonzalez.
Please, this is no time for jesting. Perhaps that madman is laying on the grounds right now. What shall I do? I offer rewards and nothing happens.
Well, he may change. Those creatures usually do, I believe. He may decide to cut the throat of someone else.
Must you always talk of throat cutting?
Oh, thoughtless of me. What you need is a drop of brandy, Excellency.
Brandy. Yes, yes, brandy. It's gone. I'm surrounded by idiots, stupid servants, stupid soldiers.
You know, honestly, your courage, your fortitude, why, a weaker man would forget his civic duty and get away from all this.
You rang, Your Excellency?
Yes, brandy.
On the desk, Your Excellency.
It's not on the desk. Bring some.
Of this sort would wreck my constitution in a week. But then I haven't the iron nerve of Your Excellency.
Come, come quickly. Something has happened in this cellar.
Through the wall. He's not human, is he?
treasure place. I'll do as he asks. Pen, paper.
Here, Excellency.
A man should consider his wife. Inez has gone crazy over the idea of Madrid. She's been at me night and day to take her there. This should do it. This should suit that maniac. Look it over.
That's very direct. But you forgot to sign.
Sign what? My resignation, Esteban. This Zorro will kill me if I stay.
But I will surely kill you if you write him all these.
But Esteban, I'm in danger. Grave danger. Diego here will bear me out.
You're in even greater danger than he thinks. So you tried to get gold out of the country, did you? If you ever again take one peso of mine, I'll cut your throat from ear to ear.
I must please ask you to change the subject. His Excellency objects to talk of throat cutting.
Quiet, you popinjay. I've no reason to letting you live.
What a pleasant coincidence. I feel exactly the same way about you, Capitan.
You wouldn't care to translate that feeling into action, would you?
I might be tempted. If I had a weapon.
Would you?
Now, please, gentlemen. No, this is going much too far.
It's only to serve you, Excellency.
Huh. You have a champion. And what a champion.
Now, gentlemen.
Diego.
I'll make it short and save you fatigue.
We have a hero with us. Are you all right, Diego?
Ask the Capitan.
Thank you.
not so firm.
Still firm enough to run you through.
I needed that scratch to awaken me.
Excellent. You shall be rewarded. Sentries! Sentries! Keep that man covered. Take him to the guardhouse and lock him in a cell. The strongest cell you have.
Why arrest me, Excellency? For three reasons. First, second, that secret stairway happens to be in your old home. And third, you handle a sword like a devil from hell. And that's exactly where you're going, Señor Zorro.
That's a pretty way to treat your future nephew, Uncle Luis.
No more of your wit. Take him away. Send the officer of the day to me. I want all caballeros and all peons summoned here at once.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
All caballeros of the district are requested to report at the alcalde's residence immediately.
At this hour?
Ridiculous. The alcalde's orders, senor.
Assemble your men for fighting squad duty.
But why did they arrest Diego? I don't know. Luis won't tell me. He must have lost his mind. Come in.
His Excellency requests you ladies to stay in your rooms tonight.
Why?
I cannot say, senora. I was ordered to tell you.
Shot. Oh. There. Okay. Now observe very closely. Blow.
You should really see something worthwhile, like changing a copper coin into solid gold.
Can you do that?
The good padre here seen me do it
many times.
It was a secret discovered by Merlin in the 11th century. Been handed down through a long line of sorcerers and magicians to today.
You can change centavo into gold?
Oh, easily.
Please, senor, do that for me, eh?
Oh, I'm very weary. I must seek repose.
Oh, senor, senor, I have a wife and 7 children, and the little iron, they ain't enough for them. Please make gold for them, and they'll pray for you, please.
Well, if I must.
Now, hold the centavo in your closed fist.
Oh, si, senor, gracias.
Tightly now.
Si, senor.
Now, put your fist well through the bars.
Oh, si, senor.
The cold iron will spoil everything. Now, I take your fist gently.
Like this. Oh, senor. Oh.
Now, open the door.
Oh, si, senor.
Si, think about it.
Come along now. Si, senor.
Now, get in. Get out of there. The wall. Think about it. And not a sound, remember?
Fox, safely trapped.
You? What is this?
Hola, senores.
What idiotic joke is this?
As if you didn't know.
Luis Quintero, you're a fool. Zorro was a man. This is my worthless trick-playing offspring.
Have you seen this one, Father?
Thank you.
Mayos, caballeros, everyone. It was very thoughtful of you to have them here.
Luis, what has happened?
Good evening, ladies.
You're just in time. His Excellency is about to make an address.
Address? What shall I say?
You know, a little matter of your resignation. Quiet! Quiet! Raise fat children and watch our vineyards grow.